Hello again. Welcome to Seasoned Citizens Present. I'm Don Lange, hosting this program for you today. Today we're going to visit with Carollynn Campbell, who is the activity coordinator for Muscatine County in the Seasoned Citizens category. What's the company we work for?
Muscatine Commission on Aging.
Yeah, I'm sorry I blew that in a little bit, but nonetheless, welcome to us, Carollynn, and we're going to kind of get an idea of all the activities that you are chairing here, and there's so many of them. I'm so happy to have you here so you can explain all these things.
We're going to keep you busy.
That a girl. We'll start out today with outreach. Would you kind of delve into the outreach program that you're going to present?
As a small organization, we do several jobs. The Commission on Aging basically is an information and referral agency, and I work very closely with the other staff in the office. We have a social worker, and we do outreach into the homes of senior citizens. Our programs are designed for anybody that is over 60, and regardless of your income, we do services for you. We have handyman, we have chore and that sort of thing. And I work closely with the social worker, and then if I see any problems or someone that needs help, I take it back to the office, and our social worker will go out and do an assessment and see what we can do to help them. So that's only part of my job.
Well, that's tremendous. I think in itself, you've already expressed, and I've already asked you, you said anyone over 60.
That's right.
I asked what gender, and you said you weren't proud. You'd accept men, too.
Anybody over 60. And we have a reputation of just serving the low income. But anybody receives our services. We have
True.
A lot of people on Meals on Wheels after a fall or after surgery. And regardless of their income, we provide services
for them. Income isn't the main factor
right.
of the program.
That's
so.
Right.
Okay.
That's right.
The next thing we could talk about briefly would be the writing classes that are offered in lieu of entertainment, I guess you'd say. I imagine that's what it's...
Well, I'm the activities coordinator. I've been in this position for about 6 years, and I hire teachers. And Lynn Jackson, or Marilyn Jackson, as she's well known, Muscatine, is our teacher for the writing classes. Lynn is an Iowa Arts Council approved freelance writer. She's had numerous articles published underneath her name. She's taught creative writing for over 10 years with us, and she's been very instrumental in our intergenerational projects. We've had three now that we've worked with grade school students with our seniors and doing some really unique things. We do an illustrated writing book every year. This is the one that we've just recently published. It's the students do the writings, and they also do the pictures inside. And we sell this as a little fundraiser for our own classes. And then on our own, Ruby Bry from our classes has put together some of her own writings for children's stories. And these make great stocking stuffers or little extras on birthday gifts. And these are available through the Commission on Aging office also.
Well, now that's very interesting. If you couldn't read this, one is called Hatching Chickens, one is called Little Brown Hen, and the other one has Salt and Pepper. Depicting, I assume, something to do with age,
they're just
possibly.
Little remembrances of living in Muscatine. We have a very wide range of ages in our classes, from 60 to 97 in our classes. So you're talking two and sometimes three generations in a class of what we call senior citizens. And we've had people that have lived here all of their life, so we have a wealth of information, sometimes just in our own little books. The students feel a special kinship with Lynn Jackson, as Lynn herself is a senior, and the students dabble in short stories and poems. They write essays, they learn correct form and function in writing, and that's very important. And the last little bit, the last class we had, Lynn began to do a series on getting things published and editing and getting things ready for publication. Which a lot of the students are really into right now. They want to do their memoirs. They have a story to tell, and they're learning how to get it on paper.
That's great. Well, that's, again, one of the aspects of this program. They have so many different features, as you're hearing, and you'll hear more as we get down the line here. Next, I think we have painting classes that are available.
Okay. Maria Norton is also an Iowa Arts Council-approved teacher, and this is a very rigorous process the teachers go through. They apply to the Iowa Arts Council. They have to submit works of art. They are judged by several different juries to receive this coveted title of an Iowa Arts approved teacher. She's developed her own unique style of opaque watercolor with graphite. Maria has designed her classes to accommodate people with low vision. She's an award-winning practicing artist. The classes are set up to try different styles and mediums. She mentions that her classes are not only art classes, but also a support group. This is one of the sample pieces that Maria has done for her classes. It's you can see it's a nice still life, and it's a rather unique. The students have the opportunity to purchase supplies at the classes. All of our classes are $1.50 suggested donation. We offer classes in Wilton, in West Liberty, in Muscatine. We try to reach the whole county, and we offer them throughout the winter months, and we have a few in the summertime too. The classes, acrylics will be starting in Muscatine at the Art Center. It's a 10-week session. It starts September 15th, and it's from 9:15 to 11:15 every morning, or every Thursday morning. In September, 13th in West Liberty, we're going to be starting at the First Church United. First Church United works with us very closely. It's a beautifully handicap accessible building in West Liberty. It's a 10-week session. It's on Mondays. It's from 9:15 to 11:15. And in Wilton, the classes will start in March of 94. Now, these classes are designed for the students to get done and be able to attend the meal sites throughout the county without loss of fun or time or to get there on time. Watercolor classes start in West Liberty at the First Church United, taught by Maria Norton, September 13th, which is a Monday, and they're from 9:15 to 11:15. Watercolor in Muscatine starts at the Art Center. It will be in March, and all classes are advertised in the Muscatine Journal in the Season Citizen column.
Okay. Now, just curious-wise, just a question in my own mind I'm going to ask. The buck and a half that's collected, I assume that's for materials and what have you.
Materials are above and beyond that. Mm-hmm. How we apply for funding for our programs, we receive a grant from Iowa Arts Council, and then, of course, we're a United Way agency. But with all the funding cuts and everything, we kind of ask the students to help subsidize us a little bit. And the teachers do this at a minimal cost.
I was going to say, either they're volunteers, as we try to do here, or they're not making a profession out of it, per se, living-wise or anything like that.
The teachers have felt the need that this is something for the seniors that need to be due, need socialization. It's good for high eye-hand coordination. It's good for just a chance to get together and socialize. It's a lot of fun. It's the students really like it.
I think it's a tremendous outreach program. Again, back to that, in a sense that you are contacting so many people, and they do get together and socialize along with learning whatever that particular class is offering.
We just took, the Muscatine County Fair was just held, and we took about 60 pieces of artwork to the fair, and we came back with about 25 different ribbons.
Isn't that tremendous?
So the quality of artwork that is produced through these classes is quite phenomenal. And we've had people that have never, ever painted before receiving blue ribbons from the fair. Having a lot of fun.
Are these watercolors? Or just
we do watercolor and acrylics. We don't do oils anymore because it's a very expensive medium.
I would assume that'd be a little
And a lot of the folks live in subsidized housing, or they have limited space, and oil is a medium that takes a lot of room, and it smells.
Yeah.
It's got a
it
smell
has an
to
odor
it,
to so. It that wouldn't be pleasant
and,
to the...
Right. So Maria has adapted our classes for our low vision, and they're just phenomenal. We have some gals that are almost totally blind, but they can see black on white. So we do a lot of drawing with Maria.
Really?
And we've enlarged some things through the wonderful photocopy machines so that people that are low vision can still participate in an age-old art of fine arts. A lot of fun.
That's tremendous. I think it's a tremendous program that you're offering there for the people around the different areas. And again, you go there so they're not forced to come to one area. You're in West Liberty, I think you mentioned.
Right.
That,
we do an outreach program like in the county in Wilton and West Liberty. Last year, we collaborated with Marilyn and Lynn. We did a wall mural at Jefferson School. We handpicked six seniors and nine grade school students. You get a chance. It's in the hall connecting Jefferson Gym to Central Auditorium, and it's about a 70-foot wall mural, and it's depicting caring and sharing.
Look at that.
It's a lot of fun. The kids had a great time, and the seniors learned so much from the little ones, and the little ones learned so much from the seniors.
Which
and they called each other Grandma and Grandpa, and they had a great time. They did a collaboration on this, and every person's idea is in this wall mural. And that the basic of it was that caring and sharing has no age limits or color limits or social boundaries, because we can care for anybody whether we can talk to them or not.
Sure.
And the kids did a beautiful job with this. So yeah, we're all over town. You just have to look for us.
Well, yes, right. Kind of look and see. All of a sudden, they'll be right there before them.
That's right.
Taking a second look at it.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, the next thing I have a little acquaintance with, so I can join in some of these things. Upcoming trips.
Oh, we do a lot of fun trips.
Yes, I know.
We have a great trip coming up. A lot of those, Muscatine seems to be a Cub fan town.
Cardinal fan.
Excuse me. Well, this trip's just for you, Don. Uh-huh. It's for both of us, both the Cubs and the Cards.
Right.
We're going to be going September 22nd. We have us reserved a motor coach, nice mm-hmm. big bus, nice reclining seats. They even have VCRs and restrooms on
mm-hmm.
them.
Mm-hmm.
And we reserved a motor coach. We're going to Chicago, to Wrigley Field, one of the ones you see on TV all the time, nice little stadium. Great seats. We're going to see the Cards versus St. Louis, versus the Cubs. $29 a seat. All the meals are on your own. And I could go along. We have a lot of fun. So it's open to anyone. So if any senior out there would like to take a son or a daughter or a grandson,
you still have openings presently.
We have a few openings left, and it's $29 a person.
So and let me tell you, you couldn't do it on your own for $29. This is a cost factor technically, because I don't think Commission on Aging really realizes a lot of money out of this.
No, we do it at cost.
I think it's technically the ticket plus the coach, and that's all you're paying for.
Mm-hmm.
And you can't, and they take you right to the door. I mean, hey. You can't go wrong with it, let me tell you. I've done it.
It's a lot of fun.
It's ideal way to go. It really is.
You don't have to drive in Chicago. Mm-hmm. Depending on what time we get there, we do a drive in the outer drive to see the lake. It's beautiful. We've had wonderful trips. And I would say about 70% of the games I've gone to, we've won. So maybe
I
need to
I'd
go.
Argue that point, of
need to go more often. Yeah, it's a lot of fun. And I was not a Cub fan or a baseball fan until I went. And I didn't realize how exciting it is to see a game actually taking progress.
Right in live.
Yeah, live. And you get to see all the fans and all the crazy costumes and all the silliness that they do in the stadiums.
You haven't done it,
it's
do
fun.
It. A day at the park is just something that you can't visualize without, like Carolyn said, she didn't know until she got there.
Right.
It's just really such an outgoing and fun day. It really is.
It is.
Plus, they stop usually at decent restaurants. You have breakfast on the way, and then lunch, you can have the hot dog or whatever you desire at the ballpark. That's your prerogative too. And on the way home, they usually stop at a restaurant with a full evening meal of your desire. Again, your
That's
own
right.
choice, of course. But I think it's tremendous.
It's great.
So do join if you haven't.
One thing that we do not allow in our motor coaches, we do not allow smoking or drinking. So
good idea.
You don't have to worry about sitting next to somebody that spills beer on you or whatever.
Blow smoke in your face.
I don't care if you drink off the bus, just don't drink on the bus.
Surely.
And we have a good time, and we want to make sure that you have a good time. That's
well,
what
I know
I'm there
you
for.
Do.
You have a great time.
So join up if you haven't. Okay, what's next?
We're just starting the fall season, September 23rd, and we're going to go to Boone, Iowa. This is a trip I've worked very hard on. It's a train ride and the Douglas Tea Room. Upon our arrival in Boone, we will visit the Mamie Eisenhower home. It's a restored Victorian home, and all these gals that are in the Victorian era are going to love this. We're going to have lunch served in the Douglas House Tea Room. It's a gourmet meal. It's all the frills that the women just love, all the china, all the fun stuff, and we'll drag you in along for this part, but then we have a part just for you. Then we will take a scenic train ride over the Des Moines River. And with it swollen right now, it might be kind of quite interesting to see what the flood damage has done.
Would be much.
And we'll visit the Kate Skelly High Bridge and the Skelly Museum. There's a story about a very young gal that crossed the Skelly High Bridge on her hands and knees to warn of an upcoming disaster of two trains crashing. And she saved over 100 lives. So it's quite an interesting story. And we'll get the story of that, and we'll see the museum. We'll have our lunch, and transportation's all included. And we're doing sign-ups for those trips already. You can call the Commission on Aging office anytime, reserve a seat. The price is $54 per person. Like I said, that includes all transportations, your admissions, and your lunch.
So and a lunch included.
Right, okay. Meal included. So it's kind of fun. It's
that
a good
sounds
day.
Like it'd be something.
There's something for everybody on the trip. I said, you know, we do a lot of things for the women, but the men like to have a fun time too.
We enjoy that. We if you allow it, you know.
We cater to it, and we spoil the men on the trips when they come.
Yeah,
we really do.
That sounds like fun.
We really do.
263-7292.
Very much
Throw
so.
Throw that in there. That's the number to call. Commission on Aging.
All right. The next trip we have is our fall foliage trip. It's going to be to Fenimore, Wisconsin. We'll lunch at the beautiful Silent Woman Restaurant, which is a former silent movie theater. We'll stop at the Cheese House, the Stone Village, and the State Agriculture Museum. And I was surprised what a wonderful display they have at the Agriculture Museum. Finally, we'll stop at the Nelson Dewey State Park, a reconstructed homestead of the state's first governor. The Agriculture Museum, which exhibits farm tools and machinery and manufacturers' models. Then we will go to a covered bridge to an 1800s village with period buildings and furnishing, including a bank, a saloon, newspaper office, blacksmith, and a general store. The price of this trip is $44. It includes transportation, the noon meal, the cheese factory, the stone village, and the agricultural center, all for $44. And we went to the John Deere Museum a while back, and the men just loved it. So I'm hoping this is as high caliber as that. So we have a lot of folks that have former retired farmers, and they just kind of like to keep in touch. And they'll say, oh, I remember we used to use this, and it's a lot of fun.
Let me again remind you, these are all chaperoned, I guess you'd call, by someone from there. So leave the driving to them. They take care of all the parking, and you know, it's just tremendous. I mean, you get off the bus and go to the different areas. It's a way to go, believe me.
We've changed our pickup site in Muscatine due to the flooding conditions on the riverfront, and Jax has very generously offered their parking lot for us, which is great for folks coming from the edge of Muscatine coming in.
Sure.
They can park there, and it's well lighted. There's phone access if something happens. And they're never left alone in the parking lot. So
that's very admirable of Jax to do
great.
That.
Yes, it's a wonderful service.
Yes,
I mean, we think it's great.
Okay, what do we have now?
Our last trip of the year is November 22nd. And we have a long list of trip goers that like to go to the Festival of Trees in the Quad Cities. Well, we've put a special twist with this little trip this year. It's November 22nd. You can start off your holiday season in style. The first time for us to attend the Trim a Tree Luncheon, we will experience firsthand how the trees get commissioned and decorated in time for the Festival of Trees. We will have a decorating and craft demonstration and receive our own keepsake ornament. The cost per person is $35. Includes transportation, the noon meal, demonstrations, ornaments, and of course the Festival of Trees. And I haven't missed it since they've started, and I have collected all the ornaments, and it's just spectacular. Everybody has to go at least once.
That's great. That's great.
And after that, I don't know how even Scrooge could be non-Christmassy. It's just,
you go
home humming all the tunes, and and they have entertainment. They have miniature displays. They have doors displays, mantle displays. They have a series for children called The Electrical Room, which is sponsored by Illinois Gas and Electric Company. They have the Gingerbread Village. It's just phenomenal.
Oh,
it's just phenomenal.
Great. Like I say, all these trips are all phenomenal, really. Anything left in that category?
Well, I think we've covered everything by the end of the year.
Well, I'm going to disagree with one because I've signed up for a boat ride on Kent. He didn't mention
that. Oh, I forgot the Kent Feed Boat Rides.
I'm signed up. Don't quit now.
Oh, we won't quit now. We are running Kent Feed Boat Rides in conjunction with Kent Feeds. This is a wonderful service they provide to the community. I go on the trips every year, and we have a sign up through our office, and we take you up and down, we take you up to the locks, and we take you down just almost to Monsanto. And you can see what the floodwaters have really done.
Yeah, this will be an exciting trip.
Quite
more so
interesting
this
year.
Right.
And we went yesterday, and it's about an hour and a half ride. You need to pre-register for the trip. So call Commission on Aging Office, 263-7292.
7292, do call it. Because I have signed up for that with another group that's going with us, so I appreciate that, and I wanted to get that in because you didn't have it on your
screen. Thank you. I forgot about that. Okay. Yeah, we do so much, I tend to forget sometimes.
Yes, I'm sure. There's so many aspects.
Yeah.
Okay, we have coming up now something that I'm going to sit back and listen because I have no idea. Brazilian stitching. Sounds fascinating.
It is. It really is. It's a three-dimensional stitching, and any of you that have been into embroidery or crewel embroidery will really enjoy Brazilian stitchery. I have a sample here from Cleo Moore. She won a blue ribbon at the Muscatine County Fair. It, as you can see, it's all fluffy and fuzzy. It's got beadwork on it. It's quite unique. The teacher of this class is Rita Hennemeister. The classes are at the Clark House. They're a 12-week session. The materials are available at the class, and it's $10 per person. It's just a lot of fun, and we've had some excellent, excellent results from this class.
So as you can, for example, here.
Right, we got a blue ribbon here. We've won best of shows in years past, and we've got a lot of fun things coming up through that class. So if you're interested, you maybe call Rita Hennemeister at 263-4460 and ask her about the class.
Okay. Now comes up another feature that women in particular, I guess men can too. Again, like we say, this is not closed. Quilting. Now that's something too that seems very interesting to talk about and visit with.
It seems to be the up and coming fad right now, Don. Okay. Nyla Morrison is a nationally renowned quilting teacher, and we have the very great privilege of having her teach this class for the first time through the Commission on Aging office. Our class is full right now, but we plan to offer this class again in the fall. We learned the basics of quilting, of piecing, using a pattern, using roller cutter. These are all foreign words to me. I'm an avid sewer, and this was something very new to me. I have taken this first class. It is so fun, and you would imagine all the colors that can be put together in different methods and modes. And I was cutting out the little pieces at home, and my son said, "This is a mathematical puzzle." And actually it is, and he was having fun arranging the pieces in different layouts and formats, and it was just so much fun. So we're planning to offer this again in the fall. It's $1.50 per session, and you need to purchase your own supplies.
Well, you can see, whatever we've talked about today has been inexpensive. The trips, the different sessions that we're offering here. So do call. We are flashing on the screen occasionally where you do call, so we're getting that across now too. Okay, I have next coming up something that's called, and I may need this, Growing Wiser.
Well, not only do we do fun things, we do a lot of informational programs. We, like I said, we are a full service agency. And in conjunction with Senior Circle, Muscatine Commission on Aging will be offering a Growing Wiser workshop. Sherry Hogerl and Kathy Dieters are presenting this program. It is at the Community College, October 12th through the 9th, from 5:30 to 7:30 in the evening. You need to register at the Community College. The number is 263-8250. And you ask for course number 33407. It's $20 for the course. It's half price for anyone 62 and older. Like I said, the speakers is Sherry Hogerl from the Commission on Aging and Kathy Dieters from Senior Circle. Some of the programs or some of the talks are going to be giving on, something that's very much close to me is memory. I can't forget, I can't remember my name, let alone somebody else's. Mental alertness, we're going to talk about communication skills. We're going to talk about decisions for the future, and we all know that growing older means a lot of difficult decisions that we have to make. Loss of life changes, and we all lose someone close to us as we get older, and how to deal with that. You receive a workbook to use through the class, which could be purchased later. There are plenty of handouts and lots of activities and discussions, so if you have questions, this is the place to go about growing wiser as you get older. It's a lot of fun.
Who could deny that? Growing wiser at any time of life is tremendous. And to think we have that opportunity as we do get into our senior years, as we are now confessing to, I think that's tremendous that they offer something like this that we can go to and abide with. So, okay, we will try to finish off the program speaking about a new program that's coming up that's going to feature Joanne Lund.
This is something that we just kind of threw together through the office. Florence in the office has been receiving newsletter and a cookbook. And it's from Joanna Lund called Healthy Choices. Joanna Lund is a gal about my age. She was working hard and about my size, and her family was getting all shipped off to Saudi Arabia because they were in the military. And she thought she better do something about this. So she started a program of alternate choices and how to substitute healthy foods in her recipes. We have a workshop featuring Joanna Lund, author of Healthy Lifestyles, Cookbook and Newsletter. And she has turned this little hobby into a business. And she's going to be presenting three different workshops then, two in the county and one in Muscatine. The first will be in West Liberty, August 31st at 10 a.m. at First United Church, which is 11,000 North Calhoun. There's no charge for this. She's going to prepare a whole meal, and we'll have plenty of questions, an answer time period. You get a chance to look over her cookbook and maybe a chance to buy one. And she's quite entertaining, we've been told. The second workshop will be that afternoon, August 31st in Wilton. And it's at 2 p.m. at the Methodist Church at 1401 Mauer. Well, we're not leaving the Muscatine people out at all, I'll tell you. We're going to be at Grace Lutheran Church September 1st at 2 p.m. at 2107 Cedar Street in Muscatine. So I hope you come along. We're going to have some free samples.
And there we go.
I'm working on getting some door prizes, and it's going to be a lot of fun.
I was just going to comment, this is where the men can definitely fall into line, because she says she's going to be doing recipes and cooking there. Whoops. And therefore, we'll be happy to test for you and check out everything how that is.
I have found that a lot of senior guys have had to learn how to cook on their own, and this is a great place to go. You know, we're used to cooking with an inch of grease, and we don't have to anymore. There's ways to cook without it. And Joanna's going to show us
how. I see here low fat, low sugar, which is particularly our age group. They're coming, or the thing. I mean, I know my wife definitely always looks at labels and checks out those factors.
Very much so.
Whenever she's buying any product, and of course tries to abide by whatever recipes that do offer this. I mean, we truly abide as we can with those things without sacrificing too much. And we still want taste, you know.
And that's what she says. You can sacrifice the fat and the sugar without sacrificing the flavor.
That's,
and that's what the class is designed
for. The problem
when
you have that, then you kind of get a little disgruntled. It's, this isn't good tasting. So you kind of lose, you know, interest in that particular thing.
So you think, what the heck?
Yeah, what am I doing? I mean,
might as well just go back to the old...
Might die and enjoy ourselves.
That's
which
right.
can be an attitude.
Anything that we've talked about today and you didn't get a chance to write it down, we hope you call the Commission on Aging office this afternoon at 263-7292. You can ask to speak to me or talk to Florence or Mary or Sherry. Anybody through the office will be glad to give you the correct information.
I utilize the phone a number of times in that case, so do feel free to call. They will answer your questions and offer any that they have knowledge of. If it's beyond their realm, then you'll have to excuse them, but I don't know what it would be, because they are in so many fields that if you call them, I'm sure if they don't know, they'll find out for you. So I can't, I think we've covered pretty much all bases that I can think of, Carolyn.
I think we've got everybody pretty well set for the winter months. We hope that
yes.
they don't sit home. They hope they do get out and socialize and get a chance to go to the meal sites,
okay, you
learn a new activity.
I do want to bring this in because I'm not sure myself. It was brought up to a degree, but the dates are starting as of September.
Right.
And then running, some of them are running into...
Into March.
To March. So
right.
they're not all just right now that you have to be getting in. They do like to have you sign up. So they have a little idea of what classes are attending. I think it's always nice to have an idea of what attendance are going to have. So.
Well, I don't know how you can think of September and not think of starting school. So,
yeah.
And I think that even as seniors, a day shouldn't go by without learning something new, or trying something new, going somewhere new, speaking to somebody new. And that's part
that's
of getting
what
older.
Keeps us going.
Everybody has something to share.
Absolutely.
That's great.
Well, Carolyn, I think it's been a tremendous information data that we've been getting here from you today, and I appreciate you taking time off from your work day to do this with us. And
well, thank you,
kind of inform us of all these features that are forthcoming. And I do hope we get a response. They are such good programs, and they're all free offerings. I mean, a few trips you have to pay for. Obviously, right. You can't expect to go on those free because the buses cost and the tickets cost. But other than that, that's just a nominal factor. Mm-hmm. So do feel free to call 7292 at your first convenience. Visit with any of the girls there, and they'll be happy to answer as much as they can. Thank you for joining us today on Seasoned Citizens Present. Thank you for TCI for allowing us to utilize your studios and to Commission on Aging for sponsoring. Goodbye.